friends! Welcome to Epic Kids Online. I'm Ashley, and I'm super excited to be spending time with you today. This week, we're going to start our time with a little game called Count the Tosses. I'm going to throw this ball awkwardly in the air because I'm not very coordinated, and I want you to count how many times I throw and catch it. Okay, are you ready? Am I ready? I think I'm ready. Okay, let's try this. Okay, that was fun. So, did you catch how many times I caught the ball? I counted 10, but I could be wrong. I think it's 10 though. Now, did you catch also how many fingers I was holding up on my left hand? I bet a lot of you were so focused on watching what I was doing with my right hand that you didn't notice anything was happening with my left hand. I was holding up two fingers, by the way. This is exactly what we're going to learn about today in our Bible story. The religious leaders were so focused on one tiny aspect of the law that they totally missed something really important that Jesus was doing. But before we get into our story, let's sing a worship song together and praise God.
Got us, y'all. Let this be a prayer right now for us, just to let him speak courage into our hearts, to speak faith into our hearts. We will not give up. Speak to me. When the silence stills my voice, you understand me. You understand me. And come to me in the valley of unknowns. You understand me. You understand me. You understand me, God. You understand me. So I throw all my cares before you. My doubts and fears don't scare you. You're bigger than I thought you were. You're bigger than I thought. So I stop all negotiations with the God of all creation. You're bigger than I thought you were. You're bigger than I thought you were, yes. Come on, tell him I believe. Well, I believe, but help my unbelief. You understand me. You understand me. So help me reach the faith that's underneath. You understand me. You understand me. Yes, you understand me, God. You understand me. So I throw all my cares before you. My doubts and fears don't scare you. You're bigger than I thought you were. You're bigger than I thought. So I stop all negotiations with the God of all creation. You're bigger than I thought you were. You're bigger than I thought you were, hands, and leave it there. Leave the rest in the Father's hands. Oh, I will rest. I will rest in the Father's hands. leave the rest in the Father's hands. Oh, I will rest. I will rest in the Father's hands. Leave the rest in the Father's hands. Oh, I will rest. I will rest in the Father's hands. Leave the rest in the Father's hands. Come on, right now, just leave it there. Whatever is burdening you, whatever is weighing you down, any worries or anxieties, just leave it there right now. Just take a moment and leave it there. And just tell him, I threw all my cares before you. My doubts and fears don't scare you. You're bigger than I thought you were. You're bigger than I thought. So I stop all negotiations with the God of all creation. You're bigger than I thought you were. You're bigger than I thought. You're so much bigger than I thought you were. You're bigger than I thought you
Jesus went to Jerusalem and stood by the pool of Bethesda. Many people were at the pool who were blind, lame, or paralyzed. Jesus noticed a man who could not walk. He had been lying there for a long time. Jesus asked him, "Do you want to get well?" The man answered, "Sir, I have no one to put me in the pool when the water is stirred up. Someone else always gets in before me." The man thought if he could get into the water, he would be healed. Jesus told him, "Get up, pick up your mat, and walk." Right away, the man was miraculously healed.
Wow.
He picked up his mat and started to walk. This happened on the Sabbath, so the Jews told the man who was healed, "It is against the law to pick up your mat on the Sabbath." The man replied, "The man who healed me told me to pick up my mat and walk." "Who was this man?" the Jews asked. But the man who was healed did not know who had healed him. By this time, Jesus had slipped away into the crowd. Later, Jesus found the healed man in the temple. Jesus said to him, "See, you are healed. Do not sin anymore so that something worse doesn't happen to you." Then the man went to the Jews and told them that Jesus had healed him. So the Jews began persecuting Jesus because he was healing people on the Sabbath. Jesus told the Jews, "My Father is still working, and I am working too." Now the Jews wanted even more to kill Jesus because he wasn't just breaking their rules about the Sabbath. He was saying that God is his Father, making himself equal to God. Jesus is God's Son, and he always did what God said was right. The man at the pool was unable to help himself. Jesus healed him, and he obeyed Jesus' commands. In a similar way, we are unable to free ourselves from sin. Jesus calls us to trust in him. When we trust in Jesus, he frees us from the power of sin and death so we can follow him and obey him.
Hey there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Lucy from Wichita, Kansas asks,
"Why does God allow people to have disabilities?"
Lucy, that is a fantastic question. You know, it's one that is really important to me because I have a daughter with a disability. She has a limb difference. And so this is a question that my family has wrestled with for some time. And so I'm glad you asked it. Well, here's the big idea, that people are born with disabilities in part because we live in a broken world. Sin has infected every part of this world, and that includes that at times people are born with disabilities, like my daughter, who only has one leg and not two. And so that's the real reason in a nutshell. But let me unpack that for a minute more, because I think this is really important. And this is something that we have really worked hard to communicate to my daughter and others. And it's this, that there are no accidents for God. That my daughter was knit together in the womb the way that God wanted her to be. And other people with disabilities are knit together the way God wanted them to be. Now, it's hard for us to understand this, but again, we remember everything God does is for His glory and our good. And so God has a purpose in disabilities. He's got a purpose in doing this. You know, we saw that in the story today with the man who was lame, that God used him to draw other people to Himself. And so we see that God can use even disabilities, things that are really difficult. And we wouldn't want somebody to be born with a disability, but God can use even those difficult things in our lives to draw other people to Him, to help us understand how good He is and how loving He is. And here's the wonderful thing, that Christ came to make everything wrong right again one day. And here's our hope. My hope is that one day my daughter will run in heaven with two legs when God has made everything right again. And so everybody who has a disability has that to look forward to, that God will make right all wrongs through Jesus Christ. So here's a question back for you. How can you show love to people of all abilities?
Over the past few weeks, we've been learning about a lot of different stories in which Jesus heals people, like the man who couldn't walk in this week's story. I want to share another special story with you about our missionary friend, Amy Carmichael, and a time that Jesus healed one of her friends who was sick. I'm going to read you a story. Amy had a very special friend named Aurelie. Amy loved her like a daughter. Aurelie had come to live with Amy when she was just 12 years old. Aurelie became part of the ministry to help other children. One day, Aurelie started to feel bad and got very sick. Everyone was very worried about her. She continued to get sicker and sicker. Amy and other friends cared for her day and night. A doctor came to see Aurelie, but he told Amy that he wasn't sure Aurelie would live. Amy was heartbroken, even though she knew that Aurelie would be with Jesus. Amy prayed and prayed that God would perform a miracle and heal her friend. Amy prayed for 3 months that Aurelie would be healed. One day, Amy realized that Aurelie was getting better. She thanked God as she watched her friend get stronger and stronger. Everyone was amazed at how God healed Aurelie. I love this story because it's a beautiful illustration of how Jesus has healed people throughout history, and He continues to heal people today. Another really cool aspect of the story is that it shows how deeply connected Amy was with her community. And part of how she got connected with her community was through adopting local dress and customs. So we learned a few weeks ago that Amy grew up in Ireland. And in Ireland, at the time that Amy was born in the 1860s, people would have been wearing dresses like this. So this is a crinoline dress, meaning it's got a big hoop, it's got a fitted bodice, and you know, it's pretty fancy. But when Amy traveled abroad to do missionary work, she chose to adopt the local dress of places that she went. So her first stint as a missionary was in Japan, and she would have worn there a beautiful kimono, which is this robe that this woman is wearing, and then an obi, which is that large sash around her middle. And when Amy was in India, she would have adopted the local dress of saris, which this woman is wearing here, and people continue to wear in India today. I have a really beautiful example of sari right here. It's just a big, long piece of material that you wrap around yourself and tie in a really cool and intricate way. And it's amazing, it's really beautiful. Not all missionaries choose to adopt the local customs or dress of the people that they're serving, but it can be a really great way to show respect for the people that they're serving and to feel more part of the community. And here's a photo of Amy in India wearing a sari, just like the one we saw. As we close our time together, let's pray. God, thank you so much for these stories that remind us that you can heal people. You have the power to heal our bodies and our souls. We thank you for these stories that are a reminder of how much you care about us. And we thank you too for all the missionaries that you've sent around the world to take care of people who are sick and injured and need your healing. God, we just pray that you would uplift them and give them strength and courage as they're helping people learn about Jesus and get better around the world. And for ourselves, God, we also pray that if we are encountering sickness or injury or things that we're frustrated about with our bodies, that you would give us peace and patience and know that you can heal us if we come to you in prayer. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Well, it was great spending time with you this week. That's all we have. We're gonna sing one more worship song before we sign off for the week, but it's been awesome. Hope you have a great week, and we'll see you next time on Epic Kids Online.